This episode of DNews is brought to you by Harry's. Cleanliness is close to godliness, or so my Midwestern mother used to say. But does that mean dirtiness is close to devilishness? Yeah, it does. Thanks a lot, science. Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. My mother hates it when people are not clean in movies. Seriously, during Lord of the Rings, she liked it at the beginning, but as they went on and got all dirty, she was all like, why can't they just take a bath? They're all so dirty. She really hates it. It's a running joke at home. But science seems to indicate that she might have tapped into a little piece of human nature. A new study published in Organizational Behavior and Human Decision Processes found that the simple act of being clean promotes ethical behavior, while being disgusted will make us lie and cheat. The emotion disgust is a complicated one. Its roots are in revulsion, unpleasantness. They can be tied to some phobias and anxiety disorders. When people feel disgust, according to the findings of the study, they will try and protect themselves, and their logical brain just doesn't interfere. It's a self-protection instinct. According to their findings, this instinct lets normally ethical people lie to protect themselves, or in the case of their experiments, for financial gain. They figured that the best way to avoid revulsion would be to introduce them to cleaning products and cleanliness. And that worked. In people who were asked to evaluate cleaning products or just think about cleanliness, the disgust was diminished and they did not lie as much. This isn't the first study into emotions affecting decision making. A 2009 study in Psychological Science found that people whose office smelled cleaner will be more ethical also. Because the office workers feel more comfortable, and all they did in that study was spritz the room with window cleaner. It even increased interest in charitable donations, with 22% of those in the clean room expressing interest as opposed to only 6% in a normal room. We'd love to see our decisions as independent from outside influence, but that doesn't seem to be the case at all. And it's not just smelling clean or thinking about clean stuff. A study done at the University of Amsterdam in 2009 found people who held heavy clipboards took things more seriously than those holding light clipboards. They literally gave more weight to things. That's not even a metaphor. I mean, I guess it kind of is a metaphor, but whatever. Sitting in a dimly lit place or wearing even sunglasses can also affect our decision making. Another study by the same researchers found people in a dimly lit room would lie about how many tasks they've completed in order to get a larger monetary reward. Being shrouded makes people feel anonymous, and that anonymity makes people less ethical and more self-interested as well. This all makes me think of dirty, dim bars and how much debauchery goes on in there, maybe for reasons related to these studies. Opposed to that, those super clean rooms of the future do make me feel a bit uneasy, like I'm too unethical for this place or something. Maybe my mom had it right the whole time. In another related study, the same researchers determined that people who had just done something unethical felt physically dirty, and cleansing themselves did make them feel better. So maybe I should just go shower. Thanks a lot, Mom. Speaking of grooming, it is currently the month of Movember, and if you are keeping that nice big fat mustache all neat and trim, Harry's can meet your shaving needs. A big shout out to Harry's.com for sponsoring this episode of DNews. Harry's was started by two guys who thought buying razors was crappy. They bought up a blade factory in Germany because, you know, German efficiency, and they are selling you high quality German blades on their website. They also have really nice face moisturizer and shave gel. The ladies think it smells nice. I know from personal experience. Go to Harry's.com and get $5 off your first purchase by entering the code DNews. Thanks again, Harry's. Have you ever noticed these mental biases toward clean or dirty? Are you gonna go find the darkest, dirtiest bar you can think of this weekend? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.